the scripture in just a minute. Ready, Jill?
Yes.
Whoever.
Yep, it's ready.
Okay. A major city's transit authority put up some ads on their waste baskets through the station. And they had this ad that was quoted, it said, "Strong, silent type in search of fulfillment and fulfilling their relationship. I'm new in town and don't know anybody. So when we see each other in the station, please give me your trash. Give me your trash." It took a while for people to realize that this ad had nothing to do with somebody realizing that they were seeking a relationship with a person, but seeking people who were looking for engaging in romance or anything else. It's a reminder to the people there to toss their trash in the trash cans that were placed around the station. But everybody's looking for fulfillment, and that's something everybody's looking for in one way or another. This kind of fulfillment that Ed was talking about was a literal kind as far as filling up the trash cans were concerned. And it was an effective one because just about everybody's looking for fulfillment in one kind or another. We all look, want to be fulfilled, full of life, full of vitality, full of happiness, success, and peace. Full of contentment. And we see fulfillment through many paths.
Okay.
If I didn't come back on time.
Many paths that we face.
Power went off.
Many paths we try to find that fulfillment. Romantic relationships, high paid jobs, more money in the bank. Relationships with their grandkids, a bigger house, kids married, going to the beach, maybe losing 10 or 15 pounds, joining a social club, and sometimes even being part of a Bible study group. Sometimes we even seek fulfillment in things that we're not proud of. Our quest for fulfillment have spawned an entire category of self-help books over the last few decades. They promised you a fulfillment and various ways, whether it's the idea of a new job or a diet or exercise or whatever, you name it. They say, well, you can do it through self-help. 40 days after the resurrection, Jesus ascended into heaven. In the gospel reading that we're going to have for this morning, he reminds his disciples of the fact that all the things that were written about him in Scripture, all through the Old Testament, had to be fulfilled before his mission was complete. The message for this morning is taken from Luke chapter 24, verses 44 through 53. Hear God's word. Now he said to them, these are my words, which I spoke to you while I was still with you, that all things that are written about me in the law of Moses, in the prophets, and the Psalms must be fulfilled. Then he said, then he opened their minds to understand the Scriptures. And he said to them, thus it is written, the Christ must suffer and rise again from the dead after 3 days, on the third day. And that repentance and forgiveness of sins should be preached in his name to all the world, beginning with Jerusalem. You are witnesses of these things. And behold, I am sending forth the power of my Father, but you are to stay in the city until you are clothed with power from on high. And he lifted, he led them out as far as Bethany. And he lifted up his hands and blessed them. And it came about that while he was blessing them, he parted from them. And they returned to Jerusalem with great joy and were continually in the temple praising God. May the Lord add his blessing to this reading of a portion of his word. He informed them that they will soon be clothed with power from on high. And of course, as Jesus said to his, and then he ascended up to heaven, leaving the disciples to gaze skyward. As we know, soon after, on Pentecost, they were clothed with power from on high. When the Holy Spirit came upon them, that is why we say that the ascension of Christ was a bridge to his fulfillment. As he ascended into heaven after the foundation of the church had been given, in today's message, we are reminded of our role in the fulfillment of Scripture. In Paul's epistle to the Ephesians, Paul tells how the church is the fullness of Christ. God, he put all things under his feet. And for them to have their hearts enlightened enough that they will know the incredible hope, the glorious inheritance, and the great power that is available to them. Everybody wants hope, inheritance, and power. Lotteries make big bucks trying to bring hope to some people. Families split up sometimes because of inheritances that are not evenly divided. Politicians spend millions of dollars in order to gain some seat in Congress or some position that they can benefit from in some office. We do just about anything to receive hope and inheritance and power. All three of these things are satisfied, fully satisfied, however, not through a self-help book or a big bank account or a higher paying job, but they're satisfied only in a relationship with Jesus Christ. Kings, etc. et cetera. He is above all in administrations and all dominions, whether it is the stock market in America or Hong Kong or Tokyo, Jesus is still in charge. Jesus is above everything. This realization should give all of us hope, especially when we are dealing with some of those people who are in charge of everything presently in our own day. The church and the role of the church. There's in church is an extension of Jesus. That is critical in the middle of it all. An example, an extension with the power to offer hope in countless circumstances across the country and around the world. On the day Jesus ascended to heaven, he told his disciples that they were the ones who would tell the world and tell the story. They were the ones who would proclaim repentance of sins and forgiveness. Repentance and forgiveness of sins to all the nations. On the day of Pentecost, their work began, and it continues even through today. The church was born and has continued as the extension of Christ on earth, even ever since. The letter of the Ephesians is first and foremost a celebration of the church. This letter celebrates the mix of people who regularly gather for worship when Christ is its head. Today, that makes includes you and me, includes young and old, rich and poor, big and little, sinners and saints, and all of these people rest under the Lordship of Christ. Christ is the head of them all, every one of those people have access to the power from on high because the power of the Holy Spirit continues to work in our lives as well. And all of us, all of them have both the ability and the responsibility to offer hope, inheritance, and power to people that are searching to find fulfillment today. Paul uses the imagery of the body, the human body, in his letters often. The body is his most common metaphor for those who follow Christ. Christ is the head. The church is the body. Church is, Christ is the head, and the church are the arms and the legs and the heart. And just as the head is never separated from the body, so the body is not to be separated from the head. The legs, hands, and heart should be crying out and embodying, carrying out and embodying the business of Jesus, doing the things that Jesus did when he walked here on the earth. Jesus' time on earth was not spent with the rich and famous or powerful. It was not spent with those people who had it all together. Not spent with people living perfect lives. Rather, it was spent with anyone and everyone living on the outside of society, in the cracks of society. He ate with dinner with the despised. He touched the leper and the unclean. He wandered with those in the wilderness. He befriended the sinner. He surrounded himself with people whom society had chosen to ignore. He went to people who were outside the temple gates because the rulers of the temple had banned those people and wouldn't let them inside the temple gates. And when he went to these people, he offered them a glorious hope, an eternal inheritance, and a great power that would enable the lame to walk, the blind to see, and the sinner to be forgiven. A glorious hope in eternal inheritance and a great power are far more valuable even today than anything that a book fulfill us in all things today and days to come. The people of Ephesus long to receive the gifts. The early believers rejoiced to receive what Jesus offered them, and they worked as his body, proclaiming repentance and forgiveness of sins throughout the world. Many were today also respond to the fulfillment we find in Christ by being his body, by serving, befriending, and loving the people whom Jesus loved, by living the same, having the same mind that was in Christ Jesus. For we are the fullness of him who fills all things. Let us go to the Lord in prayer. Father, we thank you for the scripture today that we are reminded that Jesus left prepared to leave his disciples, informed them of the fact that they were going to be the ones who were going to represent his fullness on earth. They were an extension of the work that he had begun when he sent the Holy Spirit on that day of Pentecost. And these men went out into all the known world at that time, offered their lives in service to him. As we know from traditions and history books, the fact that these men gave their lives for the cause of Christ, we ask that our faith might lead us to do the same if we are asked to do so. We ask that you continue to work in our lives that we might truly be the church, the extension of Christ on earth. For it's in his name we pray. Amen. Let's join together this morning.